This video is sponsored by Surfshark VPN. So in one of the most recent chapters of One Piece, Luffy and Zoro displayed a new form of advanced haki that we hadn't seen before, and with it, the long list of advanced forms of haki keeps extending. However, since there are so many different ways in which haki can be applied, it can easily get confusing, so I thought I would compile all of them together so that you can properly understand how every single form of advanced haki works. However, I want to make one thing very clear, and that's the fact that a lot of the classifications in this list hinges completely on speculation. This is because we do not currently have an official haki skill tree or an official guidebook that describes how haki is subdivided by Oda. So, while I will be trying to be as objective as possible, some of the things here might be up for debate, as Oda has been incredibly vague and sometimes has even gone back to retcon certain things with how some stuff classifies, so take it with at least a grain of salt. But before we start, I'd like to take a moment to talk about Surfshark. Surfshark is an app and browser extension that allows you to connect through a private network, allowing you to mask your computer or phone's information by coding it in a layer of data encryption. This protects your personal information from internet providers, corporations, or online pirates who might be trying to steal it. Surfshark also allows you to bypass region locking, granting you access to content that would otherwise be unavailable in your country. For example, did you know that the entirety of the One Piece manga is available for free from the official website? It's usually locked to English-speaking territories, but with Surfshark, you can access it right now from anywhere in the world and instantly enjoy the full series for free while still officially supporting One Piece. Surfshark is available on an unlimited number of devices with just one account and even offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you've got nothing to lose in trying it out. Go to the link in the description below and use my code ARTHUR to get 83% off plus 3 extra months of Surfshark for free. Thank you so much to Surfshark for helping support this channel, as their help makes it possible to deliver these videos to you. And with that said, let's get back to the video. So, to start things off at its most basic level, let's describe what haki itself is. Haki is considered the physical manifestation of one's own willpower. It takes one's own spirit, their will, and manifests it as energy that allows for supernatural abilities. The kanji for haki in Japanese precisely translates to ambition willpower. Specifically, ha can refer to a conqueror, a sovereign, but in this case it more represents the concept of ambition, of wanting to achieve something grander than yourself and having the willpower to do so. Ki instead refers to the Eastern concept of ki or chi, the vital energy that resides inside every living creature, which embodies one's spirit and will. Haki itself is both directly inspired and pretty similar to the concept of ki, since the concept of making one's ki flow to be able to properly attack is a key aspect in many Japanese and Eastern martial arts. Haki itself can manifest in what is subdivided into three official main categories: Kenbunshoku no haki, Busoushoku no haki, and Haoshoku no haki. The first of them is Kenbunshoku no haki. Each type of haki has shoku at the end, which means color, or essentially just means type in this case, but most fans tend to omit it, so Kenbunshoku is often just translated as observation haki. The term Kenbun means observation, to look into and absorb information, but it implies doing so through both the act of seeing as well as the act of hearing. The word Kenbun is quite literally formed by both the kanji for seeing and the kanji for hearing, so it applies to the use of both. In the island of Skypiea, it is referred to as mantra or mind rope, but it should be noted that this is simply a dialect and not a special type. In that regard, observation haki allows one to notice things in their surroundings through heightened observation or hearing, sensing the spirits of others. These can be used in different ways. On one hand, it allows one to see others even in occasions when they cannot see them physically, by sensing their visual presence and voices. This applies, for example, to people who cannot see, such as the blind Admiral Fujitora, who is still able to sense the presence of people through his observation haki. It can also be used to see things that are beyond the user's line of sight, such as when Usopp was able to visualize the silhouettes of Luffy, Law, and Sugar from kilometers and kilometers away by sensing their spirits. This can be applied on a wider range too. The priests of Skypiea were able to use it to sense people within their respective domains. Ananel was also able to use it to count how many people were conscious during his death game, though it should be noted he used his Delford abilities to create electromagnetic waves to increase his range and ability, too, so that bit is unique to him thanks to his Delfruit. Rayleigh also was shown using this to gauge numbers within an island and being able to tell how many living beings were there. Someone who has a strong spirit will also stand out more to observation users, allowing them to gauge not just numbers but also strength. Observation can also be applied by allowing one to carefully observe their opponent in battle. By looking into their intent and body language, it can allow one to predict attacks by understanding what an enemy is going to do next. This is something that is also used in real-world martial arts. This can also help avoid projectiles by carefully observing their trajectory. However, we've seen that there are ways to circumventing, such as by attacking without thinking, by having attacks hit at random, or in the simplest and most effective way, by overcoming the opponent through sheer speed and power to the point that they cannot keep up in predicting how the enemy will move next. Beyond these basic functions, Observation Haki has a series of advanced ways to apply it. The one most famously known is the one officially referred to as Future Sight. Future Sight allows one to quite literally peer a few seconds into the future, getting a direct visual image of what will happen soon near them. It's unclear exactly how this works. It could potentially just be understanding the intent of others to such an advanced level that one can perfectly visualize what will happen next, but how precise it is might just be for narrative effect. This allows one to see events that will happen in the next few seconds, particularly useful in battle to help them avoid enemy attacks. However, this is simply a prediction of how things will go as intended. The actions of the user or the actions by another party that notice the user peering into the future can change this future into something different, as the future is not set in stone until it happens. Known users of this include, of course, Charlotte Katakuri, as well as Luffy, who mastered this ability during his fight against him and later across Wano. Furthermore, during Marineford, we saw the three original admirals using a technique similar to Katakuri's, moving their shape-shifting bodies to dodge hack-infused attacks that would have otherwise hurt them. It's possible this might have been just them predicting upcoming attacks, but the high level of precision in which it was used, just like Katakuri, does suggest that this could have been Future Sight, though that remains to be confirmed. There is also potential application of even more advanced Future Sight, being Madame Charlie's ability to see into the future. Unlike normal Future Sight, this allows her to see even days, months, or years into the future, being able to foresee events even well beyond her line of sight. It's never explained if this is an application of Future Sight or just magic, so this is just speculation, but it could be a logical explanation to this otherwise mystical power given that One Piece tries to avoid relying on simple magic. This is also further hinted at by the fact that the Sea Kings also seemingly have this ability. Another implied advanced application of Observation Haki is the ability to sense the emotions of others. Some users have shown the ability to not just observe intent and movement, but to be able to completely understand the emotions of others. It's important, however, to understand that this does not seem to actually allow one to read the thoughts of others, but simply to understand how they're feeling. Luffy, in particular, is a very proficient user of this, since he is able to easily sense the emotions of others and understand them. Another known user of this is Queen Otohime, who could easily understand the emotions of others through her advanced observation haki, such as the suffering of a thief she apprehended, or the pain Fisher Tiger underwent as a slave that he was trying to hide from others. Understanding the emotions of others is likely one of the reasons why she decided to devote herself to activism in order to make a change to the sorrows that afflicted so many, as she likely understood better than anyone else the fishman's inner desire to live under the real sun. It's unclear if this is an ability that anyone can master, as it seems to be unique to those who have an affinity for understanding emotions and, most importantly, having great empathy for others. There is also a similar application of Observation Haki that could be related, which allows to hear the voices of others. This allows one not to just sense those around them on a large scale like most normal observation users can, but also to apply it to an advanced level by sensing the voices of their hearts. However, this is not a skill one decides to apply, but rather an ability that some individuals are somehow granted. The ability to hear voices specifically doesn't refer to hearing actual talking, but rather their emotions. Unlike other types of haki, this ability is always active, and it doesn't seem like it can be stopped, so it can be overwhelming in places such as a battlefield, as the emotions of those in their moment of death will be felt by the user, which might be quite hard to bear in the occasion of several people dying at once. This power was seen possessed by Aisa and Kobe, the former of which seemingly had it since birth. And there is also another advanced application of Observation Haki that could potentially be tied to this previous form as well, that being the voice of all things. Now, while this has not been officially confirmed yet, the Vivrekar data books strongly imply that the Voice of All Things is a form of advanced observation haki. Both Momonosuke and Shirahoshi, users of the Voice of All Things, were said to have observation haki, despite no other indication anywhere of having used haki in any form. Coupled with the fact that this does resemble other forms of advanced observation haki, while it's yet to be officially confirmed, it does make a lot of sense. The Voice of All Things is a special power that allows one to quite specifically hear the voices of other beings that no normal humans would be able to hear. This refers not to their actual voices, but their thoughts inside their heads, being the only form of observation haki that allows one to read thoughts, or more specifically, being able to telepathically hear others. However, it should be noted that this only applies to very specific creatures, and has only been seen with the Sea Kings, the Elephant Lord Zunisha, and the Poneglyph Stones. It's unclear why exactly this power exists, as its application is only to very specific elements that appear to have a strong connection with the Void Sentry. As such, this power seems like it could potentially exist for a purpose, rather than just existing as a random manifestation of one's own spirit like other advanced forms. It should also be noted that the Voice of All Things seemingly only allows one to hear the thoughts of these creatures. The Sea Kings seemingly have it by nature, which is how they are able to communicate with each other with humanoid language, same for Zunisha. However, they will only respond to those they wish to respond, as the Sea Kings only address Shirahoshi for being their king, despite having heard Roger and Luffy. The same happened with Zunisha, who only acknowledged Momonosuke despite the fact that Luffy was trying to speak to it. The current users of it are Luffy, Shirahoshi, and Momonosuke, though Roger and Oden also had it in their time. Next, we have the second main category of haki, Busoushoku haki. Busou translates to armament or armor, using the kanji for martial armor. In that regard, it allows one to coat parts of their body with their own spirit, creating an armor around their body. This armor is very powerful and resilient, automatically making attacks hit harder and with more punch, similar to the difference of punching with a bare fist or while wearing an iron knuckle. Beyond just hitting harder, this armor also has a series of special effects, such as being able to negate the properties of Logia and Paramecia users who wouldn't be able to be hit under normal circumstances. This armor is usually depicted with this distinct shiny black color. Before the timeskip, armament haki was not depicted visually, but it was changed as an artistic choice by Oda after the timeskip to help more easily distinguish those who were using haki, without the need to spell it out every time. However, it's still debated by some fans if this is simply a redesign of haki in general to make it more easily distinguishable, or a separate type of armament, meaning that armament could be used with or without coating it in black. Or perhaps it's just a combination of the both. Luffy referred to this as hardening, implying that it's perhaps a different form. However, Luffy has stopped using this name much after the start of the timeskip, and other characters haven't even used it at all, so it's possible that this was just an idea Oda backtracked on or just a random name he used. This is even more confusing by the fact that even after the timeskip, there are some users who used haki despite no visual hardening, though some people argue those are just mistakes by Oda. It's impossible to say for sure, however, I'm leaning towards the fact that this was just a visual redesign, considering that Oda drew Rayleigh's haki like hardening in future flashbacks, despite it not being there originally. It's still possible there is a way to use armament without it looking black, or perhaps those really are just mistakes, but in general, at this point in the story, everyone uses hardening by default anyway. That said, let us move to the advanced forms of armament haki. On a basic level, one's armament can be used as an armor to hit others with a lot of strength, as well as by passing devil fruit properties. It can also be used defensively to protect one against strong attacks, even including things such as blades that would otherwise cut someone's body. Strong users can hone their armament further to the point that they can overwhelm the armament haki of others, causing damage to their opponents even if they use armament, such as by being able to cut someone's body or doing significant damage. Next is armament imbuing. This is the ability to imbue one's haki into an object, such as a blade, a mace, an arrow, or a bullet, by imbuing this armor into an object rather than their own body. This makes said weapons able to attack with extra power and be able to hurt devil fruit users. It also allows the weapon to not sustain damage by making it more resistant, which is used by master swordsmen to keep their blades pristine. However, there is an advanced degree to which this can be applied, as using it enough will implicitly turn the blade permanently black. This type of blade is known as a kokuto, or black blade, which includes the legendary swords Yoru and Shusui. However, it would appear that while this sword becomes permanently coated black, becoming much more powerful, it doesn't necessarily retain haki properties if the user doesn't apply them, as Zoro was able to slice Monet without hurting her despite using a kokuto to do so, though some have questioned this just being a mistake by Oda. This is still vague as it was only mentioned offhandedly, and its connection with armament haki are still a little bit unclear. Armament haki can be applied to any region of the body, which leads us to our first advanced form, full body armament. This form is simply achieved by applying haki to the entirety of one's body, from head to toes, which seemingly takes some degree of skill to achieve. However, despite how undeniably cool this looks, this form of haki is not quite convenient. It might look intimidating, but it is a waste to apply one's haki all over one's own body. It's been explained that haki should be condensed where it is needed, as using it in unneeded areas is superfluous. That is why powerful warriors are often seen only applying it where it is necessary. As such, full body users have a reputation for being easily defeated once they go full body, as seen with Virgo, Pika, and Bullet in Stampede. Luffy applies full body haki in Gear 4th, though he only cuts parts of his body to benefit from being coated in haki, avoiding any superfluous use. Something Luffy also applies in Gear 4th is a form of advanced haki with no clear official name at the moment, being referred to by fans with the nickname of Tribal Haki or Swirl Haki, as it makes the haki on one's body appear in the form of tribal flames. This seems to appear where one's devil fruit powers are mixed in with haki, such as Luffy applying the rubber properties of his body while still coating it in haki when in Gear 4th, or Katakuri combining it with his mochi powers. This is further strengthened by the fact the anime indicated these tribal flames are actually meant to be the swirls of a devil fruit. In the case of Luffy and Katakuri, their tribal haki also takes a special color beyond black, being red for Luffy when in Gear 4th and blue for Katakuri. This leads us to our final form of advanced armament, which allows someone to let their haki go beyond the armor and float out of their body in an ethereal form. This is often called by fans Ryuo, since according to Hyogoro, haki is called Ryuo in Wano, which translates to flowing sakura. However, it's unclear if this refers to a universal name for all three forms of haki, or if it's referring to just this advanced form of haki, and it's still up for debate if this should be used as an official name or not. So, personally, given the pose that a lot of characters take to use it, I would like to call it the Macarena haki, so screw it, we're calling this the Macarena. So at a basic level, the Macarena allows one to make their haki flow outside their body to make attacks hit way harder. These can then be applied by letting the haki flow in such a fashion that it hits the opponent for extra damage, sort of like a piercing shockwave. We saw this being used by Sentomaru, Boa Sandersonia, Rayleigh, and the three admirals all performing the Macarena together. Okay, I'm sorry, Macarena sounds a bit too dumb, so let's call it Armament Flow. At a capable enough level, the armament flow of this haki is strong enough to hit someone with a shockwave without the need to touch them, as someone like Rayleigh and Sentomaru were able to do, something Luffy specifically pointed out. We've also seen this applied in the clash between Roger and Whitebeard, where the flow of their haki was so strong that their weapons did not even touch, though it should be noted this was also while applying a different form of Conqueror's haki we'll get into later. However, there is also another advanced form of this that goes one step beyond, called Internal Distraction, which allows one to make the haki flow into the target and destroying it from the inside. These can be used to destroy objects from the inside, as well as attack opponents from the inside, seemingly allowing one to bypass certain impenetrable barriers such as the skin of the Yonko. Rayleigh was seen using this at Sawaodi, and Luffy later learned it at Udon, seemingly being able to destroy a tree from the inside as well as different types of exploding collars and shackles. That said, it's important not to confuse this with the advanced form of Conqueror's haki showed in the most recent chapters, as I mistakenly did in one of my previous videos, because that is a separate form of haki, which can be combined with armament flow and internal distraction, but is its own thing. So let's talk about that. Our final main category for haki is Hao Shoku no Haki. Hao translates to Conqueror King or Sovereign King, though fans usually shorten it as just Conqueror's Haki. Hao uses the same ha as in haki, which means conqueror or one with ambition, as this type of haki is only possessed by those with the ambition to overcome others and reach for the top. This ability, unlike basic observation and armament, can only be attained even at a basic level by a few select individuals, said to be one in several million people. However, it should be noted this is not a power gifted at random, but simply something that only awakens in those whose willpower surpasses that of almost all other living beings. In other words, if you don't have conquerors, then that's on you not having enough strength of will, as only the most ambitious are able to awaken it. At a basic level, Conqueror's Haki allows one to emit an energy blast of their willpower that overwhelms the will of others. This will cause those with wills weaker than the user's to feel overwhelmed, being frozen in fear or simply startled, with those who are particularly weak by comparison outright fainting. If someone's will is closer in level to the user, then they will barely feel the effect. This blast can be applied to a very large crowd, allowing one to deal with several weak enemies at once without having to bother fighting them. It is implied that when learning to properly use it, it can target specific targets in order not to hurt allies. This has also been seen as a way to tame wild beasts. By suppressing the haki of the beast with their own, a conqueror's user can intimidate a beast enough so that the beast runs away or refuses to fight, just like when used against normal people. If the beast's will is weak enough compared to the user, then it will also faint like a normal person. Conqueror's haki can also manifest itself when two conqueror's users clash, creating a conqueror's clash that sends a shockwave that can physically push objects away. The stronger the conquerors of the users, the more devastating the shockwave will be. The shockwave is usually drawn with black lightning sparks, but it is important to note that said sparks are also used even outside the context of conquerors, so it can be questionable if them appearing is a use of conquerors or not. Also, conqueror's haki from a more powerful user will also often result in items shattering from the strength of their willpower, cracking wood and other surroundings when used. Conqueror's haki has one mainly known advanced application which was only properly explained just recently, being what I'd call conqueror's coding, an ability only very few specific individuals, even among conqueror's users, have. This allows one to code their own body or an item with their will of conqueror's haki, making their attacks so much more devastating. This was used by Kaido to imbue his Ragunaraku attack on Luffy and later picked up by Luffy to use against him. It is also implied to have been used by Roger and Whitebeard in their clash, as well as Zoro more recently, though I've heard some debate on if Zoro was using Conqueror's coding on his sword, thus allowing him to slice Kaido, or if Kaido simply sends Conqueror's in Zoro from this mighty attack, or if Zoro used the Conqueror's shockwave to startle Kaido and give himself an opening. There's different interpretations to this, so we can't see completely for sure, meaning it's still unclear if Zoro does possess Conqueror's coding, but at the very least, it does seem like Zoro does at least have basic Conqueror's. Anyways, this advanced Conqueror's haki can also be stacked on top of armament haki like we've seen, which also includes being able to combine it with armament flow. Supposedly, the advanced level of armament flow to the strength from the inside can also be stacked together with this Conqueror's coding. There's been confusion over whether Conqueror's coding is its own thing or the same thing as armament flow, as the two are often used together, and I even mistakenly confused the two in a previous video. It's understandable since Oda's love for using black sparks even outside of Conqueror's use makes it hard to distinguish when users are using Conqueror's coding and when they aren't, but after thoroughly looking into it, I believe they are two separate things. After all, Kaido hit Luffy with Ragunaraku while still touching him, while instead, in a later attack, the two of them were not touching, despite both attacks, using Conqueror's coding. Furthermore, Luffy has used armament flow and internal distraction without using Conqueror's, indicating that armament flow, which allows one not to touch their opponent, and its advanced form internal distraction, is separate from Conqueror's coding, which can be used while still hitting an opponent. However, the two can be combined together for extra damage, which, as Luffy pointed out, made his attacks, which were still to duel, powerful enough to actually stand against a Yonko. An easy way to know that Conqueror's coding is being used is that it seems to leave a trail of black lightning sparks when using it, and the stronger the user, the bigger this trail will seemingly be, with Luffy's trail still not being as big or as visible as the other confirmed users, Kaido, Big Mom, Roger, and Whitebeard. And that's all the forms of haki. So to recap, we have the color of observation haki, which can be applied to sense the presence of others by seeing and hearing their spirits, allowing to gauge enemy strengths and numbers, as well as predicting one's moves through careful observation. Advanced forms include future sight, emotion sensing, voice hearing, and implicitly the ability to hear the voice of all things too. Potentially, future telling could also be an advanced form of future sight. The color of armament haki can be used to coat one's body in armor, also negating the invulnerabilities of devil fruits. Coating can also be applied to items, such as sword or projectiles, and doing so to a certain extent will implicitly forge the sword into a kokuto, a blade that remains permanently black. This coating can be applied to the full body in full body armament. Another form consists of combining armament with one's own devil fruit abilities, which will result in a swirly pattern on their bodies akin to that of devil fruits, and the last advanced form of armament haki allows it to flow outside the body so it hurts an enemy as a shockwave, sometimes without the need to touch them. To a more advanced level, it can also be used for internal distraction, destroying items or opponents from the inside. Finally, there is the color of Conqueror King's haki, which can be applied by emitting a shockwave that will cause those of weaker wills to feel overwhelmed and those of even weaker wills to faint, which can also be used against animals and wild beasts to intimidate them and scare them away. Two Conqueror's users clashing will also result in a shockwave. Advanced Conquerors can be applied by imbuing Conqueror's Haki like one would imbue armament, in what we call Conqueror's Coding. These can be stacked on top of normal armament Haki, as well as other forms of advanced armament Haki, such as the two stages of armament flow. When used in combination with the likes of Future Sight, it is possible to use all three types of Haki at an advanced level at the same time. So with all that said, we only have one follow-up question left. How many types of advanced Haki does Luffy currently possess? Whew, that's a lot. Luffy has really been devoting himself to mastering all these types of Haki, which has allowed him to become a lot stronger across the post-timeskip. It's Luffy's willingness to always adapt and learn from his mistakes that allows him to grow stronger. But that's every single form of Haki so far in the series. I hope this video was useful to you in some way or another, and that it helped you better understand the fascinating power system in this series. As a reminder, go to the link in the description below to get Surfshark VPN and get access to the entirety of the One Piece manga officially for free right now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Dale a tu cuerpo, Haki Macarena, Macarena, ¡ay!